Yes, good morning. Today we have a lecture by Elena Pivovarova from Ijevsk in Russia, Udmurt State University, and she will talk about stability and stabilization of steady rotations of a spherical robot on a vibrating base. Work with Killing, Alexander Killing. Please, Elena, it's you. I think it's good to turn off the video.
Okay. Can I start?
Yes, yes, please go, please, please.
Okay, first of all, I would like to thank organizers for this possibility to make this report. And my talk is about stability and stabilization of steady rotations of a spherical robot on a vibrating base. This problem is closely related to the dynamics of rigid bodies with a vibrating point of suspension. The simplest and best known example of such a system is a one-dimensional pendulum with a vibrating point of suspension. It's a Kapitsa pendulum, and the problem of the dynamical stability of an inverted pendulum in the presence of vertical vibrations was first investigated by Stephenson, and later this problem was also treated by Kapitsa, who apparently did not know about the results of Stephenson. So they show that this inverted pendulum is stable at high frequency of the oscillation of the point of suspension. And in our work, we consider the motion of a spherical robot, which consists of spherical shell and axisymmetric pendulum, which move on the horizontal plane, which oscillates in vertical direction. and these oscillations are periodic. And to investigate this system, we choose three coordinate systems. The first one is a fixed coordinate system. The second one is a moving coordinate system, rigidly attached to the spherical shell. And the third one is also moving coordinate system, but rigidly attached to the pendulum. Third axis of this system directed along the symmetry axis of this pendulum. orientation of pendulum and spherical shell we will defined by the matrices Q and S, which consist of projections of eigenvalues, unit vectors of fixed and first moving coordinate systems onto the axis of the third moving coordinate system. And the evolution of the components of these matrices is governed by such kinematic relations, where omega small and big is as the angular velocities of the pendulum and spherical shell, respectively. And v is the velocity of the center of the shell. We suppose that the motion that the system moves without sleeping, so we have such non-holonomic constraint. And also we suppose that the shell moves without losing contact with the plane, and so we have such holonomic constraint. The Lagrangian function of this system has the following form, and using this holonomic constraint, we can rewrite Lagrangian function in such way. And here we have omitted the constants and total time derivatives. The equations of motion of the system can be represented in the form of Lagrange equations, where lambda is undetermined multipliers, and using non-holonomic constraint, we can eliminating linear velocities and obtain such non-autonomous system of equations describing the change of angular velocities of the shell and the pendulum. And this system with these kinematic relations form a closed system completely describing the dynamics of our system. These equations of motion admits following geometric integrals, and Lagrange integral, which we represent in such form, where m is dimensionless momentum, and it related to the angular velocity of the pendulum in such formula. here parameter eta is mass distribution, correspond to the mass distribution of the pendulum and the shell. And we can rewrite such integral in terms of angular velocity of the pendulum in such form. Also, this system has dimensionless analog of the area integral and the Chaplygin vector integral, which have such form. The energy of the system is not preserved and has such form. And also equations. These equations has a symmetry field which correspond to rotation of the pendulum about its symmetry axis. And in this work we will assume that oscillations of the plane occur according to such law, where A and omega are amplitude and frequency of oscillations of the plane. And we can present our system in Hamiltonian form with such Hamiltonian function. And here theta is rotation angle, p is corresponding dimensionless momentum, tau is dimensionless time, k1 and k2, kappa 1 and kappa 2 correspond to the constants of integrals f1 and f2 respectively. This Hamiltonian has three parameters, two of which correspond to the parameters of oscillations of the plane, its amplitude, and this parameter correspond to the frequency of oscillations. And the third parameter correspond to the mass distribution of the system. And also this Hamiltonian has two constants of integrals. And our goal to this in this work is to analyze the stability of vertical rotations of our system. And it is easy to show that this system has two families of partial solutions, which correspond to vertical rotations, where axis of the pendulum is directed along the vertical. By upper rotations, upper vertical rotations, we will assume that the center of mass of the pendulum places above geometric center of the system, and lower rotations correspond to the case when the center of mass of the pendulum is below the center of system, geometric center of spherical shell. And it is easy to show that Hamiltonian is invariant under such transformations. And using this symmetry, we can examine only upper rotations instead of considering the upper and the lower rotations separately. In this case, we need to redefine the domains of definition of parameters in such a way, and after this redefinition, the upper rotations will correspond to the values gamma is greater than zero, and the lower ones to the values gamma less than zero at the same value theta is equal to zero. Vertical rotations in general correspond to the invariant manifold kappa 1 is equal kappa 2 for upper vertical rotations, and kappa 1 is equal minus kappa 2 for lower vertical rotations. But after this redefinition, we consider only one case where kappa 1 is equal to kappa 2. And on this invariant manifold, the Hamiltonian takes the following form, where zeta is the square of angular velocity of the pendulum about this symmetry axis. And upper vertical rotations correspond to such equilibrium point where theta is equal to zero and p is also equal to zero. And first we analyze linear stability of vertical rotations. For this, we expand Hamiltonian in series up to order 2 in the variables theta and p, and we get such expression. we note that the quadratic part of Hamiltonian completely coincides with the quadratic part of the Hamiltonian for the problem of the motion of Lagrange top with a vibrating point of suspension and for the problem of the dynamics of the Kapitsa pendulum. And we should note that this Hamiltonian does not depend on the parameter eta, which corresponds to mass distribution. The mass distribution of the shell and the pendulum does not influence the linear stability of vertical rotations of our system. The equations of motion of the system can be reduced to Mathieu equation, and stability of solutions of vertical solutions for the Mathieu equations. Mathieu equation is well studied previously, and stability of vertical rotations are described in for Mathieu equation by the Einstein diagram, which presented in this figure. Here, white regions correspond to stable rotations, gray regions correspond to the unstable rotations, and boundaries of these regions emanate from these points, and on these boundaries rotations are linearly unstable. Now we would like to define which regions correspond to upper or lower rotations. For this, we construct such diagram where onto the plane of parameters, onto the space of parameters, delta, kappa, and angular velocity of the pendulum. And in this space, the plane gamma is equal to zero divides all space into two regions. So this region corresponds to upper rotations, and this region corresponds to lower rotations. So if angular velocity of the pendulum is equal to zero, then negative values of kappa correspond to upper vertical rotations, and positive values of kappa correspond to lower vertical rotations. And in this figure, we construct only for positive values of kappa regions of stability and instability, both for lower and upper rotations. By red lines correspond to the boundaries of stability regions for upper vertical rotations and blue lines correspond to the boundaries of regions of stability for lower vertical rotations. And these figures constructed for various values of the angular velocity of the pendulum. And by white regions correspond to the regions of parameters where and as upper and as lower vertical rotations are stable for the same parameter values. Dark gray regions correspond to the unstable regions for lower and upper vertical rotations. And light gray correspond to the case when rotations are stable only for upper or for lower position. So we can see that for big values of large values of angular velocity, there exist large regions where upper and lower vertical rotations are stable at same parameter values. And one more important question which we should analyze, it's analysis of reactions of the system. That is the question when the system moves without loss of contact with the plane. And for this we present the reaction in such form. The vertical component of reaction is in such form, and in new variables in theta, this vertical component can be rewritten in such way. And for vertical rotations, this expression reduces to such simple expression. And as this expression depends on time, then we should find minimum of this function, and minimum of this function is defined by such simple expression. And minimal value of reaction is zero. Condition that the minimal value of reaction is zero leads to such simple equation. This equation defines in the space of parameters two planes, two such planes, which divide the space, parameter space, into several regions. So this region where minimal value of reaction is greater than zero correspond to vertical upper vertical rotations without loss of contact, and this region correspond to the lower vertical rotations which when the system moves without loss of contact. And we will use parameters from the regions where the system moves without loss of contact for following examples, which we will consider. And now we can onto the Einstein diagram, we can indicate which regions correspond to the motion with or without the robot losing contact with the plane. And by hatched regions correspond to the case where system moves with losing contact of the plane, and unhatched regions correspond to the case where the system moves without losing of the losing contact with the plane. And we can see that if angular velocity of the pendulum is equal to zero for upper vertical rotations, there are no regions where vertical rotations will be stable. And for some small value of angular velocity, we can see that for upper vertical rotation there exists some small region where the motion the system moves without loss of contact. Yes, without loss of contact. And we can conclude that if angular velocity of the pendulum is equal to zero, then it is impossible to stabilize upper equilibrium point by oscillations of the plane without it losing contact with the plane. And here I would like to give example of Kapitsa pendulum, in which the question of reaction at the point of suspension is not raised. But as we noted above, linear stability for Kapitsa pendulum and for our system is equal up to some change of some parameters. So this diagram are also applicable for Kapitsa pendulum. And as the Kapitsa pendulum is a one-dimensional pendulum, that the angular velocity of the rotation is equal to zero for all parameters. So it is impossible to stabilize the Kapitsa pendulum with a unilateral constraint, for example, on the plane. And also we can conclude that the pendulum, when the pendulum rotates with any non-zero angular velocity, the upper vertical rotations of spherical robot can be stabilized by small oscillations of the plane in such way that the robot moves without loss of contact with the plane. And also, we can conclude that for any angular velocity of rotation, the pendulum of rotation, the pendulum, there exists a maximal value of amplitude of the amplitude of oscillations, such that when this maximal value is exceeded, it is impossible to stabilize upper vertical rotations without losing contact with the plane. And the next, we consider non-linear stability of this system. For this, we expand Hamiltonian in series up to order 4 in such form. And next, we reduce this Hamiltonian to normal form. The first, we make a change of variables. Such change of variables. So after this change of variables, the Hamiltonian takes the following form. And the next, we make a near identity change of variables, similar to Birkhoff transformation, which reduce Hamiltonian to such form, where C is this coefficient C is calculated from such integral. And if C is not equal to zero, then the solutions is non-linearly stable. So solutions in these regions are non-linearly stable, except for the case when C coefficient C is equal to zero, and setting C equal to zero, we obtain such condition for degeneracy of the Hamiltonian. And this condition corresponds to the such surface in the space of parameters. And this surface consists of a countable number of pieces whose projection onto the plane kappa delta coincides with the Einstein diagram. And stability analysis of equilibrium points of the system for parameters lying on this surface requires expansion of Hamiltonian up to higher order. if we will consider the question which regions correspond to upper or lower rotations, we can conclude that when eta is less than 1/2, the surface intersects all parts of the degeneracy surface. That is depending on the values of parameters, degeneracy of our or lower stable rotations can occur. And also there exists some value at the starting from which the plane gamma is equal to zero will not intersect the degeneracy surface. And it surface will completely lie in the region for vertical upper vertical rotations. And in conclusion, we consider example of the motion of a spherical robot on a oscillating plane. For this, we use full scale specimen of the spherical robot with axisymmetric pendulum drive. This robot was designed and constructed in the laboratory of nonlinear analysis and new types of vehicles here in Zhersk, in Udmurt State University, jointly with Kalashnikov and Zhersk State Technical University. And this spherical robot has the following values of parameters. And as was noted above, for this example, we will use values of parameters for which the system moves without losing contact with the plane. The first, we choose some frequency, some oscillation frequency on the of the plane, some constant value of the oscillation frequency. And in the space of parameters, it correspond to the such plane, inclined plane. And here, the next, we choose some constant value of amplitude of oscillations in order to the motion was without losing contact with the plane. And we choose such value. And the value is have such value. Here, by points A, B, C, D, we indicate sets of parameters for which the system, the vertical lower or upper rotations are unstable for points A and C, and stable for points B and D. And in this figure, we construct period advance maps of the system under consideration in a neighborhood of the vertical rotations. And this numbers A, B, C, D correspond to these points on this parameter space. So we can see that for points A and C, the vertical rotations are unstable, and for points B and D, vertical rotations are stable. And we can see in this diagram the same conclusion. Within the framework on the model considered by changing the angular velocity of rotation of the pendulum. One can stabilize vertical rotations at all values of the frequency and amplitude of vibrations of the underlying plane, which lie in the region of rotations without the robot losing contact with the plane. But in practice, it is difficult to stabilize to stabilize rotations on the vibrating plane, which with large amplitudes, because the stability regions very small, as we can see from this diagram, that for large values of delta, it's very small regions. So I think it's all. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you for the talk. So please, are there questions or comments? Eduardo, I cannot hear you. No sound, Eduardo.
Eduardo, talvez seja o fone. Tenta tirar o fone e falar. Tá sem som.
Não, Eduardo, é... não tem som.
Ok. Ele vai sair e vai voltar. Maybe the connection is better.
Someone has questions? Comments? So maybe I have a question, a little question. Just you show a robot, a true one, and there is your robot. But I suppose your robot is very difficult to make, indeed. That's true, Elena?
Yes. This robot is it's investigation for ideal model of the spherical robot, and for real spherical robot, it is influence of friction and of non ideality of construction, so it's difficult to make a robot that will be moves as described in this book.
I suppose also you did to put at this to attach at the center of the sphere the Lagrange pendulum,
yes.
And this,
yes,
of course,
yes,
not
yes.
Easy. And then, if I understand, you put the ball on the table, and the table is vibrating vertically.
Yes.
And you don't want it jump. You prefer it doesn't jump.
Yes, we don't want it to jump.
Eduardo?
Well, I don't know. I don't know if the question was already if the subject was mentioned, but I mean you're assuming from start that the shape of the top is symmetric, right?
Yes. Yes, top is symmetric. Axisymmetric.
Yes. But yeah, so does it? Is it become really complicated when you don't assume that?
Yes. You are right.
Mm-hmm. Also, well, I should say I really. I enjoyed your presentation, since very thorough, the study you did. How much control do you have, like, when you draw those diagrams, the instrat, you know, is the regions of stability, right? How much analytical control you have over them? Like, what can you say analytically versus numerically? I don't know. I couldn't hear about that. Do you understand what I'm asking?
Yes. What is proved and what is not proved?
Exactly. Basically that, yes.
What is proved or not proved? What?
In the instrat diagram, I think that's the stability diagram for parameter plane.
Right. This diagram was studied in many works, and so we do not investigate the stability. No. We do not prove the stability of or instability of these regions, and as we check that in our case, this diagram describes stability and instability regions as numerically and as analytically.
Mm-hmm. Any other question?
I have a question.
Yes, Hilbert.
Hello?
Hilbert?
Yeah.
Si?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Elena, thank you for the nice talk. I have a question. You said that the mass distribution does not influence the linear stability.
Yes.
Does it influence the nonlinear stability?
Yes. For nonlinear stability, the mass distribution the parameter is here, and for nonlinear stability, the analysis is different from the for example, for Lagrange pendulum, yes, and this term differs from the case of Lagrange pendulum, where the parameter. With this parameter, this term differs from the case of Lagrange pendulum.
Okay, thank you.
Yes. Other question?
There is a question in the chat.
Read it, please. I don't have the chat.
Yeah, it's from Jason. she already working with problems with electrical loads.
No.
Electric loads.
Yeah. No, we didn't work with problems with electrical loads.
Maybe I have just a comment that I visited your laboratory in Izhevsk, and there is very nice laboratory experiments with, and I remember the balls, the rolling balls, and that's very interesting. It's unique when we visit other places, usually there is no laboratory of experiments. Any question? Eduardo, again, we don't have the sound.
Yeah,
and the microphone is off.
Okay, Annette. No, I just had a historical curiosity about Stephenson's pendulum, I think you mentioned in the beginning of your talk. Wasn't that something you mentioned?
Stephenson?
Stephenson? At the very beginning, I think, first or second slide. Yeah, I guess that, yes. I mean, the system that he considers is basically the same as Kapitsa's pendulum.
In the for linear analysis, our system is same as Kapitsa pendulum, and this simplest example of the dynamical stability of the system by oscillations.
Yeah.
By oscillations.
Was that the first example? Does anybody know of such a mechanism for stabilization of a stable equilibrium?
First example of stabilization?
Yeah, with this mechanism of oscillating, you know, some parameters, changing some parameters.
The stabilization was considered in this works by Kapitsa and Stephenson. And nonlinear stability was shown only in if I find this work in by Markiev and Bardin in this work, the nonlinear stability was proved for this system.
Thank you very much, Elena. Once again, it was a very nice talk.
I have another question.
Yes, Idberto.
Yeah. In the Kapitsa machine, the vertical the suspension point, in fact, describes a circle. It's not a strictly vertical, right?
It's one of way to realize this system, as I understand.
Yeah. But you can also put a pendulum on the table and the table is oscillating. Probably. Okay.
Do you mean both up and down and sideways?
Yeah, the suspension point is in the extreme of the rigid rod. So it's really not a vertical segment because the length of the rod is the radius of the circle. Strictly speaking, it's not a vertical oscillation of the point of suspension, but is this
it's an arc.
Considered in the equation?
When the point not vertical oscillation?
It's a very small arc.
Yeah. The
point is on the circle, in the circle. The radius of the rod.
We didn't case where the point in circle oscillates.
Yeah, for small oscillation, of course, you can disregard this the radius of the circle. You can think of the vertical oscillation of the point of suspension. But for a larger oscillation, the motion of the suspension point is on a circle.
Yeah.
Okay. So probably there is Jeff, you have a question? Yes, please.
Is this a Hamiltonian system still after the perturbation?
Yes, it's a Hamiltonian system.
So, how can you have a asymptotic stability in Hamiltonian system? Your picture, the graph showed it's asymptotically stable. So, in the experiment, the first pendulum, the simple pendulum.
Maybe it's
the graph you showed is asymptotically stable, but this is a Hamiltonian system. How do you have asymptotic stability in a Hamiltonian system?
Maybe time-dependent Hamiltonian system.
It doesn't matter.
Even
if it is time-dependent.
Yes, time-dependent.
You don't have asymptotic stability.
No.
You have periodic time-dependent Hamiltonian. You still don't have stability, asymptotic stability. There must be something that I missed.
Here we don't have asymptotic stability.
But the first picture, your graph, I mean your machine, the first page.
Capizza.
Yes.
Yeah. So yeah, in this case, you have a graph that shows that asymptotic stability.
Yes. Yes.
So this is not a Hamiltonian system in this case.
Yes.
Yes or no? Is it Hamiltonian?
Is it Hamiltonian? Yes.
But then, if it's a Hamiltonian, you never have asymptotic stability.
Maybe I cannot answer your question.
Yeah, you might have stability, but your picture that shows it's asymptotic stable, so that's not possible.
I understand you, but I cannot comment this. Sorry.
I must have missed something.
Okay. Any other question?
Isn't it a constraint system where you are in a submanifold or not submanifold? But...
Well, to be precise, on a stable manifold. But then that's not, then you don't have stability. If you have any point that's asymptotically stable, that means you have to have a point which is unstable. So therefore, you can't get stability. I mean, it's a Hamiltonian. You cannot have anything asymptotic.
Yeah, but on a submanifold, you could.
Yeah, once you have a submanifold in, then you must have a submanifold out.
Yes, but maybe you select one. I don't know. I didn't understand.
Yeah, you must missed something. It can't be right if it's Hamiltonian.
Yes, but here we cannot get Hamiltonian asymptotic stability.
Yeah, you can. That's the Hamiltonian picture, exactly.
Yes, yes, yes.
For myself, I didn't have in mind that Capizza is asymptotically attracting. I mean, it's just stable.
Yeah, it can only be stable. So it cannot, the oscillation, the amplitude cannot decrease. So basically, it's a sustained some kind of an oscillation.
Yes, yes. So any other question? Maybe I have a question. There is another intermediate between Capizza, let's say, and your model. You just, if you put just a Lagrange top on the table and a vibrating table, this should be known also. Lagrange top on the table and the table is vibrating.
Yes.
I don't know.
The stability of Lagrange top with oscillating point of suspension was also investigated, and if we put the Lagrange top onto the plane, then and we fix this top.
Yes.
If we fix top, then we get the system where was studied in this
okay.
Work.
Okay. Sorry. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Going back to Jeff's question, in the picture, aren't you varying a parameter? You're not looking at a fixed system.
That would do it. Yeah, if you vary the parameter, so it's no longer Hamiltonian. That's a kind of a responding system. So you can design a mechanical system to do that. That's correct. Exactly. But if it's a fixed periodic oscillation, then it's a Hamiltonian. So if you have a feedback system, then it stabilizes and make it asymptotic stable.
Okay. Any question? Okay, maybe we thank the speaker again. So Annette, it's up to you.
I will stop the recording, so if you want to open your cameras to take a picture.